Hello students, today I will start the lesson Christianity and Islam. Since ancient times, many religions rise and developed throughout the world. Among these, Christianity and Islam are the important two religions. Here, these religions spread across the world, though the Christianity and Islam were established after the first century CE. These two religions established only after the first century CE and spread throughout the world. They are known as Semitic religions. These two religions are known as Semitic religions. Semitic means the people of Middle East are called as the Semitic races. So these two religions are called as the Semitic religions. Here they basically originated in Central Asia and spread to different parts of the world. So originally they rise and developed in Central Asia and spread throughout the world. Now the Christianity, it was established in the beginning of the first century CE in Nazareth province of Palestine. It was under the reign of the Roman Empire. This religion was under the rule of the Roman Empire. Jesus Christ was the founder of Christianity. Before the rise of Christianity, the Jews of Palestine had become the slaves to superstitious practices, and that they faced many difficulties, many hardships due to the misrule of the Roman emperors. In such a condition, Jesus Christ was born and founded the Christianity to purify the Jews. He founded the Christianity. Here the life of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ was born into a poor family of Joseph and Mary at Bethlehem village near Jerusalem, and he did not get proper education, but he acquired a lot of religious knowledge. Though he is not get education properly, but he get a lot of religious knowledge by his extraordinary intelligence, extraordinary power of intelligence, and interpreted the holy book of Jews in a simple language. You know, he got the mastery over other religions, and he interpreted the Jews holy book in a very simple language. He, at the age of 30, he came under the influence of John Baptist, and he was baptized by the John Baptist. He enlightened the people in distress and poor by his divine teachings and made them psychologically strong, because he encouraged the people. He encouraged the people with his teachings, by his divine teachings, and he made the people psychologically very strong. This made him very popular in that region, and people called him as a Messiah. So because of his teachings, he was called as a Messiah. Messiah means the messenger of the God. And day by day, his services to the poor and depressed class increased, and he became more and more popular in Roman Empire. Gradually, the people condemned him. Some people became jealous about the growing influence of Jesus Christ, and the people considered him as a godly man. That time, the priestly class of Jews opposed the ideas or the teachings of Jesus Christ. So they complained against Jesus Christ to the governor of Roman Empire, Pontius Pilate charging him a treason. So because of his work, because of his religious reformation, the other priestly class, the priestly class of the Zeus, they complained against him to the governor of the Roman Empire for charging a treason. Therefore, after the trial, he was taken to the Golgotha. Jesus Christ was taken to Golgotha Hill on a Friday, and he was crucified on a cross. Today, the Christians observe this day as a Good Friday, because on that day he was crucified on the cross. So the Christians, they observe that day as a that Good Friday. Now his teachings, Jesus Christ taught his principles in a very simple language, in a common language, in a regional language, between the age of 30 to 33 years. With these teachings, he laid the foundation for peace and compassion in the human society. The main teachings of Jesus Christ are: God is one and he is the most merciful. The first teaching of the Jesus Christ is that God is one and he is the most merciful, and he is the creator of the whole universe. It was his first teaching. And second, he taught that everyone should develop the brotherhood feeling about the others. We have to develop what type of feeling? We have to develop a brotherhood feeling about the others. And thirdly, love the people who are in distress. We have to love the people who are in distress, who are in trouble. That is equal to worshipping of God. When we help the poor, when we help the invalid people, it is equal to the worship of God. And fourthly, one should serve others without expecting anything from them. The fourth teaching of the Jesus Christ was that one should serve the others without expecting anything from them. That is, selflessness service is the most important. Then serving people is equal to the worship of God. Serving people, serving poor people is equal to the worship of God. And if one repent his mistakes, God will forgive him. If anyone he repent for his mistakes, then God will forgive him, or God will excuse him. And lastly, love your enemy. We have to love our enemy, because we have to do good to the others who try to harm us. Therefore, he told that we have to love our enemy who try to give trouble to us. We have to love such type of people or the enemies. These are the main teachings of Jesus Christ. Now the spread of Christianity. Here, when Jesus was alive, he entrusted the responsibility of spreading his teachings and helping the people in distress to his 12 disciples. He appointed 12 disciples, and these disciples, they were called as the apostles. They spread the teachings of Jesus Christ. Most important among them was Saint Peter. Saint Peter was the most important disciple of the Jesus Christ, and he went to Rome and established and sent missionaries all over the world. Peter Saint, he established a church and sent missionaries to all over the world and spread the Christianity. Now the contributions of Jesus Christ. Here, Christianity has taught the noble principles of peace and brotherhood to the world. You know, the most important contribution of the religion was that he taught the principle, he taught the ideas of peace and brotherhood to the world. Now educational centers established by the church and missionaries helped the growth of education. It also helped, Christianity helped the growth of education, because the church, they started number of schools. The missionaries, they also started number of schools. So they helped the growth of education and literature. Now the Christianity has introduced the Gothic style of architecture. It also developed its own style of architecture, and that style is called as the Gothic style of art and architecture. Now the missionaries have extended health services to all over the world. They also provided health services, health service facilities to the poor and depressed class people all over the world. Like this, it also provided health facilities to the people all over the world, and the women and weaker section have been largely benefited by the education. You know, the women, they were deprived from the education, but when Christianity came in the world, it gave education to the women. So the depressed class and women are able to take the education. This has brought the qualitative changes in the society. It brought the qualitative changes in the society, because before the Christianity, women were not allowed to take education, and poor, they are unable to take the education. But the Christianity, they are giving free education to both women and the depressed class people. So it benefited women and the poor class people, and it helped the development of the qualitative society. It made a qualitative changes in the society. And now afterwards, some people opposed the teachings of the Jesus Christ, and the Christianity split into two parts. They are the Catholic Church and Protestant Church. Some people, they protested, they revolted against the teachings, against the preachings of the Jesus Christ, and they founded their own sect. That was the Protestant cult or the Protestant church. Like, there are two sects in Christianity. It is about the rise and the birth of Jesus Christ, his teachings, and his contribution towards the world. Now, afterwards, the Islam. Islam, you know, it is originated in Arabia. It developed in Arabia. You know, Arabia, it is a peninsula in West Asia. It is basically a desert land which is not suitable for the agriculture. You know, desert land, it is not suitable for the agriculture. So the Arabians, they migrated to fertile land and settled in places where water was available. Like, you know, Mecca and Medina, their water is sufficient. So they migrated to Mecca and Medina. In the beginning, Arabs worshipped many objects like nature, rivers, and streams. As a god, Kaaba was considered to be one of the most important places. You know, the Arabs, what they worship? They were the worshipper of nature, rivers, trees, and streams. And, you know, Kaaba, it was considered to be the most important religious places. You know, Kaaba means it is a rectangular stone. It is considered as a most important worshipping place by the Arabians. Now the Prophet Muhammad was born in 570 AD. It Prophet Muhammad. Prophet Muhammad born in 570 CE. At Mecca, his parents were Abdullah and Amina. Abdullah was his father. Amina was his mother. But he lost his parents in his childhood, and he was brought up by his uncle. You know, his uncle, he brought up Prophet Muhammad, and his uncle was in the beginning a shepherd, and afterwards he went on travels in the other parts of the world, started visiting Mecca, Syria for business purposes. He visited Mecca and Syria for the business purposes. In Mecca, he was introduced to a rich widow by name Khadija. You know, Prophet Muhammad, when he went to the Mecca, there he was introduced to a rich widow woman called Khadija, and employed him. Later, he married Khadija. They had two sons and four daughters. When Muhammad traveled to different places for the textile business, his business was the textile business. When he was in textile business, he came across the principles of Christianity and Judaism. He came across the principles or the teachings of the Christianity and Judaism, and he was influenced by these two religions. He started meditating deeply for long hours on Mount Hira to find the remedies for the social and cultural outcomings of the Arab people, to find the remedies, to find the solutions for the outcomings, shortcomings of the Arabian people. He sit for a meditation for a long hours. After Paigambar achieved attainment or enlightenment, when he attained the enlightenment, he was called as the messenger of God by the people. When he attained the enlightenment or Kevala Jnana, that time he was called as a messenger of God. Messenger of God means prophet. Prophet means messenger of God. When he got the enlightenment, that time he is called as the prophet. Prophet means messenger of the God. And his principles became very popular among the people, and many his messages were accepted by his disciples. They were considered as the messages of God by his followers. His teachings were considered as the messages of the God. Such collections of messages were composed. They were all compiled in a book, and it was published, and it is called as the Quran. Today, the Quran is a holy book for the Islamic religion. Like, you know, Christianity. In Christianity, the Bible. In the Bible, the teachings of Jesus Christ were summarized, were compiled in the book called Bible. So the holy book of the Christianity was, Christianity is Bible, and the holy book of Islam is Quran. In Quran, what is there? In Quran, there are the principles of Prophet Muhammad. In Bible, it contains the principles of Jesus Christ. So these are the books, for holy books for the Christianity and Islam. Muhammad started preaching his principles in Mecca when Paigambar opposed polytheism. he started his preaching his principles and he opposed the one idea of the Arabs, that is the polytheism means worshipping many gods. He opposed polytheism, so the people enraged and they planned to kill Prophet Muhammad. When he opposed the polytheism, that time people opposed Prophet Muhammad and they planned to kill Prophet Muhammad. So that time he traveled from Mecca to Medina in 622 CE. So in 622 CE, he left Mecca and went to Medina. That travel is called as the Hijra. That is called as Hijra, means journey of Prophet Muhammad from Mecca to Medina in 622 CE is called as Hijra, and it became the Hijra era. That is, Islamic lunar calendar is based on that Hijra. Islamic lunar calendar is based on that Hijra. That is 622 CE. The people of Medina welcomed Prophet Muhammad and his principles. After 8 years, there was a war between the Mecca and Medina, and the people of Medina defeated the people of Mecca. Paigambar came back to Mecca. That time he once again came back to Mecca after 8 years. The people of Mecca accepted his teachings. That time the people of Mecca, they accepted his teachings. He was welcomed, accepted his teachings and also his religion. Finally, they became the followers of the Islamic religion. Gradually, his principles spread all over the Arab region, and Prophet Muhammad died in 632. 632 CE, Prophet Muhammad was died, and his important teachings are here. Islam means submission of oneself before the God. Submission of oneself before the God, and it means the Muslim, God and Muslim means follower of the God. They were the followers of the God. The main teachings of Islam are God is one. The main teachings of Islam, that is, God is one. God is one. He preached that God is one. And here, a simple prayer is enough to win the heart of the God. God is one. Only simple prayer is enough to win the heart of the God. And secondly, he taught that one should lead an honest and chaste life. One should lead one should lead an honest and a principled life. Honest and principled life. Principled life means a simple life. Everyone should lead what type of life? Honest and a very simple life was taught by the Prophet Muhammad, and should keep away from all the bad habits. Keep away all the bad habits. Thirdly, he taught that one should have respect for women and compassion for the poor and weaker section of the society. We have show compassion for the poor and weaker section of the society, and one should respect the women. These are the main principles of Islamic religion or the Prophet Muhammad. Now the rituals of Islam, there are five important rituals in the Islamic religion. The five important rituals are Kalima. Kalima means belief in one God or belief in Allah. That is Kalima. Here Muhammad is his prophet. We have to believe in Allah, and Muhammad is his prophet. That is Kalima. They have to follow that principle, the ritual. Now secondly, Namaz, that is prayer for Allah for 5 times in a day. Pray God or pray Allah 5 times in a day. That is Namaz. Then Roja, you know, Roja, that is fasting in the month of Ramzan. It is also one of the important ritual of the Islamic religion. Now Zakat, that is we have to keep aside part of our income for the sake of the poor people, for the sake of the depressed people. That is definite sum to be spared in the income to give to the poor people. That is Zakat. A part of our income is kept for whom? For the purpose of the poor people, for the purpose of the weaker section of the people. Now Hajj, that is a pilgrimage to Mecca once in a lifetime. These are the five important rituals of the Islamic religion. Now spread of the religion. After the death of Prophet Muhammad, caliphs took over the responsibility of spreading the promoting Islam. After the death of Prophet Muhammad, means in 632, his disciples, they are called as the caliphs. Caliphs, they took the responsibility of spreading the principles of Prophet Muhammad. They were also known as the successors of Muhammad Paigambar. With the sincere efforts of the caliphs, Islam spread from Syria, Spain to India within a century. The reasons for such fast growth are within one century, it spread from Spain to India. That is simplicity of Islam. Widespread to other countries, widespread from Spain to India because of its simplicity. Its principles are very simple, so it spread in a century. Then efforts of caliphs to spread Islam, devotion of Islam or devotion of the Muslims is also important reason for the spread of Islamic religion. And religious interest of the sultans, you know, the Mughal sultans, they have interest in the Islamic religion. They accepted Islam as their religion. So the interest of the sultans and conducive political situation, these are the main reasons for the spread of Christianity. Now its contribution, after accepting Islam, Arabs have been known for the following contributions. Here, medicine for measles and other diseases and book on medicine was produced. You know, they wrote a book on the medicine for the measles. Then new invention in science and mathematics, new invention in science and mathematics took place. And third, the spread of knowledge built by the church, built by the medieval Arab and Persia in the field of geography, astronomy, and other parts of the world. Means there is a spread of knowledge. There was a spread of knowledge in the field of geography, astronomy to other parts of the world. And Islam influenced the art and architecture. It also influenced the art and architecture. You know, the Christianity, what type of art and architecture they influenced? They introduced their new art and architecture, that is the Gothic style. They introduced, and like the Islam, they also introduced their new style of art and architecture. You know, the Islamic art and architecture, that Gothic style is the architecture of the Christianity. Here, the domes, gold gumbas, it is a dome. So they established domes. That a new style of art and architecture was also developed by the Islam. These are the contributions of the Islam. But here also, two sects are there in Islamic religions. The most important among them are Shia and Sunnis. Shia and Sunnis are the two sects of Islamic religion. And successors of Muhammad, Paigambar, are known as Caliphs. Caliphs, you know, Caliphs.